Thank you. Amen. God bless you, pilgrims. We want to greet you in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. So wonderful to see all of you, amen, in the house of the Lord. And those that are streaming, may the Lord bless you too, amen. Let us all stand. I've been redeemed by this love divine, amen. Redeemed by the Lord, amen. I've been redeemed by love divine. Oh, glory, glory. Christ is mine. All to him I now desire. Saints, amen. Let's sing that song. Hallelujah. The end is here, amen. It's now at hand. Amen. Ask our brother Chester, amen, to open a meeting in prayer. Hallelujah. I look and see that story being
all, she's gathering around the repeat word of the hour. You can see Israel, amen.
Israel's awake.
Nations are breaking, amen.
Nations are breaking.
Amen. Our prophet told us, our prophet told us. The next verse.
Have you considered the end-time message? Have you considered Malachi 4? Revelation 10:7 and 10:17 proclaims this message now and then forevermore. Crossing over from mortal to immortality, amen. The bride is gathering, amen. The world is failing. We can see all around us.
Israel's awakening.
Oh, nations are breaking. Our prophet taught us we believe the end.
Let's bow our heads before the Lord as our brother takes us to the Lord. If you have a need, you can make it known by raising up your hand. Hallelujah. Amen.
Let us bow our hearts and pray. Atate, mzina la Yesu Kristu, tabalansu, mazulu anu. Mozi jebeta kwa mbili ba masobanu, po dzi wazajiko ndi jimene mwari jionetera, po tulola kutitifige nsumkaji suwanu unu. Mlemegezege mulungu wanga jifuwaja iji. Mama uja mwadipatsa zomwe munatikonzera mmene tinabwera pa gomelano. Mwatiuza kuti inde ife ndi unstoppable seed ya Abraham. Mlemekezeke chifukwa cha chimeneja. Tabweranso pano kuti tidzapeze double portion ya mtsiku la lero. Tipemphera mtumiki amene mugwiritse ntchito mu nthawi ino Ambuye kuti olankhula asakhale iye koma mukhale inu Mulungu amene mutilankhule. Pali tonse amene tili ndi zosowa zosiyana-siyana monga mmene tili losiyana Ambuye kalankhuleni aliyense mu mtima mwake pokwaniritsa zosowa zake. Yes. Mulemekezeke Ambuye kumbukirani onse angakhale iwo amene akuchita stream Ambuye. Yes. Kawakumbukirani chimodzimodzi. Kumbukirani abandi, ma elders onse pompano Ambuye, ma trustees, ma deacons. Yes. Abusa athu angakhale amene swali kujopeka Ambuye kawakumbukirani chimodzimodzi. Mulemekezeke ndikutamandika Ambuye tisekuleni mitima yathu. Ndikuti mawu anu akafikire poyenerera pamene akabereke zipatso zabwino. Tipemphera mzimu woyera kuti utisogolere mwachina chilichonse Ambuye. Tipemphera izi mu dzina la Yesu Kristu. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Brunga gdarise. Amen. God bless you. Amen. You may be seated, saints. Amen. Amen. The Lord knows all the languages. This morning, the brothers prayed in Afrikaans, and tonight is Chichewa. Amen. We thank the Lord for His grace. God has got His bride. Amen. All over the world. Amen. While the deacons take the evening tithes and offerings. Amen. I don't know if Brother Brighton, you know the song Almost Home? You know that song? And then we can come and sing it together. Amen. We almost home. Amen. We can sing it together, saints, and we can just learn the song together. Amen. We're almost home. Amen. Brink of cross. We are at the brink of crossing over. Amen.
Almost home. I'm almost home. I've got a mansion waiting, and I'm almost home. Ooh, almost home. Well, I'm almost home. I've got a mansion waiting, and I'm home. The best is now. They took Apostle Peter. Need him all because he will not deny the Lord as he had done before. They hung him by his feet to die. They thought he was alone. Look up to what heaven and said, Lord, I'm coming home.
Almost home.
Well, I'm almost home. I've got a mansion waiting, and I'm almost home. Oh,
almost home.
Well, I'm almost home. I've got a mansion waiting, and I'm home. Apostle John, they took Apostle John out, calling in the hall to die. But he had great connection with the Lord, and he saw the new Jerusalem. They thought he was alone. He said, it's not so hard to die if you can see your home. I'm almost home. I've got a mansion waiting, and I'm almost home.
Almost home.
I'm almost home. I've got a mansion waiting, and I'm almost home.
Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. We've got our mansion, amen. Hallelujah. Our new body waiting for us. We are almost home, saints. Let us all stand. Thank you, Brother Brighton. Amen. You appreciate Brother Brighton?
Amen. Amen.
So wonderful, amen. Yeah. Appreciate him as well, amen. Hallelujah. Let's sing that song, Going Home, I'm Going Home. There's nothing to hold me here. Amen. Whether your job, anything, I can hold the Son of God here and the daughter of God.
Many times in my childhood we've traveled so far. By nightfall our weary heart grows. Father's arms will sleep around me, as I had said, he hope I am good,
we go. There is nothing,
absolutely nothing,
to hold me here.
I caught a glimpse of that heavenly land, even by faith. Oh, I caught a glimpse of that day.
One key up, brother.
I am going home.
Now the toilet is filled. Hey.
Now the twilight is fading, and the day,
well, Brother Wilson, comes
soon shall
I get homesick, amen. Are you homesick for heaven?
But my Father's led me each step of the way. But my Father has led me each step of the way. And now I'm going home. Hallelujah. I'm going home. Oh, go.
Thank you, Lord, that you spoke to us this morning. God, Lord, to bring to our remembrance once again who we are, that we were chosen in you from the foundation of the world. And you placed our names. You wrote it, O Lord, with your own blood on the Lamb's book of life. And Father God, O Lord, no one can erase it. Father, we thank you, we praise you, we worship you, we glorify you. Thank you that you chose us in you, Lord Father. God, thank you, Lord, that we have come back for more, O Lord Father. More of thee, O Lord Father God. We had it all, but yet we desire to have more of thee. We have come with our cups tonight, Lord. And Father God, that you will fill it for us, Lord Father. God, Father, Lord, as the prophet says, God, we become, Lord, what we eat. And we want to eat the living word tonight again, Lord. Father God, you said, O God, that man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that comes from the mouth of God. Thank you for your word. Thank you for the song leaders. We pray that you will bless them. Thank you for the musicians. Will you also bless them? Thank you for every son and every daughter of thee that has come, O Lord, to the house of God tonight. Bless them, O Lord, Father. And we pray for the minister tonight, Lord, that you will bless him also, Lord, Brother Stanley, and that you will use him, O Lord, for the glory of God and for the benefit of the body of Christ Jesus. Those also who stream, O God, Father God, the service, we pray that you will even bless them. And Father God, let the Holy Spirit also grant them their portion. There's our dear pastor, Lord, that must also come home, O Lord. Whenever he needs to travel home, will you bring him safe, O Lord, Father? It's dear wife also, Father God. We pray for all the saints that went to Pretoria this morning. Hallelujah to the memorial service. Oh God, we pray that you will take them safe home, all of them, Father, and bless our service, Lord Father, as we wait upon thee, O Lord, to speak to us again. In the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Amen.
Thank you, Lord. God bless you, dear saints. Thank you for being back in the house of the Lord. We want more of him. That's why we hear again. We hear from God again. We've got some prayer requests here. God bless you, saints.
Please pray for my aunt, Pauline Smith. The house burnt out this afternoon. So we trust and pray that the Lord will comfort and sustain and strengthen the family. And we thank the Lord that nobody burnt out. So it's only natural things that they lost, but we trust and pray that the Lord will restore them and also strengthen the sister that went to hospital for smoke inhaling. Praise God. And then also, Shalom Saints, please remember Ugaya in your prayer for accommodation. This person needs a house, a roof over her head, and we trust and pray that the Lord will provide for her also. And dear Saints, I am going back to Namibia on Tuesday the 28th. Please pray for me. Thank you for your welcoming spirit and love from the pastor, his wife, and the believers to me. The ministry was a big blessing. Love, Sister Sophia Maton. We trust and pray that the Lord will take our sister safe home, and we appreciate the Lord for her daughter and her family that kept her here on holiday a couple of months, and I trust that the Lord will bless her and bless them and bless you all. God bless you, Sister Maton. We appreciate you, and we will convey the message to the pastor and his wife as well. And as we know, the pastor is again in, he went to Pretoria, and pray for him that the Lord will grant him safe passage back home. All the other saints that also attended the memorial service, that the Lord will take them all safe to their various destinations. And then Tuesday evening, we will have our regular service at 8 p.m. And Thursday, we have a cottage meeting in Mitchell's Plain. It will be at the house of Sister Amanda Davids. The Lord bless you all. Let us sing the song while we welcome our brother Stanley to the pulpit. Stanley, for into thy presence we come.
Into thy presence we come,
not by the word,
not by the word we enter,
but by thy grace.
Christ, we just want to thank the Lord tonight, and indeed we have come into his presence. So without taking much time, let us open our Bibles to the book of Isaiah, chapter 64. So just want to fellowship for a little while, just encourage each other in the word of the Lord. Isaiah 64, verse 8. If you are there, I'll read. And maybe while it's at that, we can also put our fingers on John 6 and John 15. Okay, let's read Isaiah 64, verse 8. But now, O Lord, thou art our Father. We are the clay, and thou our potter. And we all are the work of thy hand. May God add a blessing to the reading of his word. Let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you, Lord Jesus Christ, this evening once again, Lord, that you have gathered us in your house. Lord Jesus, you promised that where two or three are gathered in your name, in their midst you'll be there, Father. Lord, without a shadow of doubt, we believe that God, you are in our midst. Lord Jesus Christ, Father, you are in the song service. You are going to be in the preaching of the word and the hearing. I commit myself into your hands, Lord Jesus, Father God, and my brothers and sisters here. We desire, Lord, that you fellowship with us around the word, so that when you go out of this place, Lord, may we be better people than we came in, closer to you, Lord Jesus. Bless this service tonight in Jesus Christ's name. Amen. You may be seated, saints. So we appreciate everyone for coming to the house of the Lord tonight. So I just want to talk on the plan of election and reprobation. The plan of election and reprobation. And the prophet says, is the wisdom of God revealed in all ages. So is the wisdom of God revealed in all ages. So we just read there Isaiah 64, saying that God is our Father and we are the clay, and that, you know, he's our potter and we are all the work of thy hands. So God is the potter, and you know, like the potter molds, you know, his vessels on clay, it means he does what he wants. The moment you speak of that, then it all speaks about the sovereignty of God. The potter shapes the vessels in whatsoever way he wants. He does not ask the vessel permission. Do you want to be a cup? Do you want to be a plate? Do you want this decoration or this whatever marking? He just does it. You see? So we already see the sovereignty of God. So some things, you know, are known in God's sovereignty, and many things we cannot really explain. We don't explain, we believe. Amen. You know, we are believers. Amen. Because how would they explain Jesus Christ at the pool of Bethesda, lifting all the lame, all those that were sick, and going to that particular man with 38 years of infirmity? Your human natural compassion will tell you, well, maybe this man, something is wrong. Because he's leaving everybody else, and then he's going to this particular person. You know, but we are not using human compassion. Amen. So tonight, let's just leave our human compassion. It is this place, we'll leave it aside. Amen. Because our human compassion, most of the time, misleads us. Amen. That's why many times, you know, maybe to a brother or sister, they are just as good as their last mistake. The moment they make an error, then this is not a believer, this brother is this sister is that. Because agape, I mean, filial love stretches so far, and human compassion stretches so far. But now God's compassion is not about that. God's love is an election. So Jesus Christ left everyone, and the prophet says divine compassion is to do the will of him that sent you to do it. That's divine compassion. So there's human compassion, there's divine compassion. So divine compassion is about the will of God. So Jesus Christ at the pool of Bethesda, leaving all with water heads, what, the lame, the blind, and going to that particular one. Because he moves by vision, remember? Amen. He says, I do nothing except my Father shows me. Yeah. So he was being led to that particular person. So your human compassion, you say, but this one is worse off. Yeah. This man maybe is not at the point of death. Yeah. This one is the point, why didn't he start with this one? It does not work that way. Yeah. You know, divine compassion is the will of God. Right, John 6, no man can come to me except the Father which hath sent me draw him, and I will raise him up at the last day. So no man can come except Jesus draws him, the Father.
And John 15 says, you have not chosen me, but I've chosen you and ordained you that you should go and bring forth fruit, and that your fruit should remain, that whatsoever you shall ask of the Father in my name, he may give it to you. So we have not chosen him, unless if one couldn't addict John 6:44, but he chose us. So we are talking about the plan of election and reprobation, about this great potter who does what he wants with his vessels. You know, and you want to put back God back on the throne. They dethroned him through the church ages by works, trying to buy salvation by works, right? But we are saying in these end times, we have a man who have put on God back to the throne. And he's saying, yeah, you have not chosen me, but I have chosen you. Now, when we look at this, the prophet says, as usual, when one regarded a verse superficially, he comes up with a superficial understanding. You see? So superficial means you're just scratching on the surface. And the prophet is saying, if you look at scripture and you just, you know, scratch on the surface, you also come up with a superficial understanding. You know, and many times we've heard the pastor saying, yeah, and it's from the message actually, that our mentality, denominational mentality, is that, you know, good people go to heaven and the bad people go to hell. Yeah, well, but you need to qualify that good. What do you mean by good? You see, the young man, outwardly speaking, the rich young ruler, looked very good. Yeah, very good morally, clean. He has not committed adultery, had not done this, had not done that, kept from the young man, but he ended up in hell. Right? Rahab, the harlot, with all the bad things in the book, the woman at the well, defiled body, but a pure heart. So what do you mean by good? When you say good people go to heaven. In your eyes, is the woman at the well good? Is Rahab good? That's the human eye, right? But God's eye, that's good. Amen. And the Pharisees who were clean morally in their lineage to be a Pharisee, to be in the Sanhedrin, you have to be perfect. Yeah. But in God's eyes, vipers. Right. All right. So now the message is broad. God just brought us this message. It was preached. And the prophet says it's broadcast to all. All. God, seven times around the world the prophet went. And the message went everywhere. But though it is broadcast for all who come within the range of the message, he that is an ear. Right? It's broadcast. There are people within range. But the people within range, it's a diverse people. We must understand that. Okay? As John foreran the first coming, the message will foreran the second coming. That was Ohio River, right? When he was baptizing the 17th person. But how did John foreran? They were the priests and the Levites who were asking him, who are you? Huh? And then there were those who heard John and Andrew and went and spent a night with Jesus. There were those who heard from the same Elijah, but still hung on to the baptism of John. And you find them later on in Acts 19 at Ephesus, Paul rebaptizing them. So the message is broadcast to all, but there are some who are wondering who John is. There are some who listen and leave him and follow Jesus. There are some who are hanging on to the baptism and they have to be rebaptized again. Right? That message is received individually. Amen. By only a certain qualified group in a certain way. Amen. So the message, we are seated in church tonight, but the message is heard individually. Amen. It's not a group. That's why we're not in the business of discussing groups and churches. The message is heard individually. There's no group or this tabernacle, or that tabernacle, or this pastor and that pastor. The message is heard individually. Now, if we talk about church, we might be tempted to believe that we are all believers. We are not in this church tonight. Hard truth. Why? Brother Bram says there are three kinds of believers in every gathering. In fact, it's actually a message, three kinds of believers. It's there. So if you talk about a group, I'll tell you every group. And Brother Bram says, if I tell you to come out of the system, where am I going to take you to? To the Branham Tabernacle? And he says, just as bad. So you have to go into the God's provided place of worship. That's Christ. Jeremiah 18. The word which came to Jeremiah from the Lord saying, arise and go down to the potter's house, and there I will cause thee to hear my words. Then I went down to the potter's house, and behold, he wrought a work on the wheels. And the vessel that he made of clay was marred in the hand of the potter, so he made it again, another vessel, as seemed good to the potter to make it. So Jeremiah is learning, is hearing the Lord's words in the potter's house. So the potter's house, as he does his work, is preaching to the prophet that we are dealing here with a sovereign God who does what he wants. Amen. With who he wants. And he deals with us as individuals. Romans 9. So then it is not of him that willeth, nor of him that runneth, but of God that showeth mercy. It's not about willing. Right? For the scripture says unto Pharaoh, even for this same purpose have I raised thee up, that I might shew my power in thee, and my name might be declared through all the earth. So Pharaoh, according to Paul, and Brother Bram preached what Paul preached, was raised up specifically for God to show his power. Amen. Therefore, hath he mercy on whom he will have mercy, and whom he will he hardeneth. Thou wilt say then unto me, why dost ye yet find fault? For who hath resisted his will? Nay, but O men, who art thou that rebellest against God? Shall the thing formed say to him that formed it, why hast thou made me thus? Hath not the potter power over the clay of the same lump, to make one vessel unto honor and another unto dishonor? From the same 16 elements, one vessel is unto honor and another unto dishonor. What if God? Okay, these are question marks, eh? There's question marks at the end. So God is in everything, is in question marks. God can hide in a coma. God can hide in a full stop. A coma can signify 2,000 years. Jesus Christ can quote Isaiah and live at a coma because he's, and say this day the scripture is fulfilled and leave the other for the end time 2,000 years later. So those are question marks. Don't ignore it. Please. What if God, willing to show his wrath and to make his power known, endured with much long suffering the vessels of wrath fitted to destruction, and that he might make known the riches of his glory on the vessels of mercy, which he hath afore prepared unto glory? We are talking about the plan of election and reprobation. So Paul is picking up and say, what if God makes a certain vessel of wrath to show his glory to the vessel of honor? Later on, I'll read a quotation. Brother Bram says, God does not reprobate for the sake of reprobation. He reprobates for the sake of the elect. What if God, that he might make known the riches of his glory on the vessel of mercy, which he had afore prepared unto glory, even us whom he has called, not of the Jews only, but also of the Gentiles. God is sovereign, saints. Now, Brother Abraham says, Arminianism makes the will of the Father not a sovereign purpose, but merely a complacent desire, as it stands back to see what all men do with his good and gracious gifts and even life eternal. So that's Arminianism. So it can be an Arminianist or whatever, or it can be an Arminianism in the message. You think that God just died on Calvary, so that someone who feels sorry for him. That this man who died on the cross of Calvary, the man from Galilee and is bleeding, right? I feel pity for him, let me believe in him. You know, so you are making the will of God not a sovereign purpose, but you are making it a complacent desire to stand back that God is just waiting for someone to feel sorry for this man of Galilee dying on Calvary. Yet again, there's a Nicolaitan class of people. They did works as a means of salvation or to be admired by men. So it can be a Nicolaitan in the message. And you believe that, you know, your works, you can work to gain God's favor. Wrong again. Right? He called you. He chose you before he chose him. Brother, you know, the Bible says, what love, you know, I can't quote it verbatim, that a man can lay down his life for his friends. Huh? So when you were at the lowest of the lowest, when you were hopeless, God reached down for you. That's why you cannot love him. You cannot make anything worse to make him reject you. Because he loved you when you were at your worst. That's me. I don't know about you. So, works will never take the place of faith in God for our salvation. Good works will not save you, but they will come out of a saved life as a fruit unto the Lord. Amen. I believe in good works, and I believe you do as well. Amen. But then, even a man who is not saved, he ought to do good works. Yes. To be a good citizen. Amen. And what is actually horrible in the sight of God is for a man to do evil works and then say that they are doing the will of God. That's terrible now. You cannot justify your sins and bad works just because you're saying you're going Calvinism. The extreme, which is wrong again. So, Brother Abraham says, it's not him that wants to get saved that's saved. It's him that's saved by God's choice. Esau wanted to get saved too. He wept bitterly and couldn't find no place to repent. So Esau wanted to get saved. He willed. He really willed. He looked for that place. And God said, I've mercy on whom I will have mercy. Before Esau or Jacob either was born, not knowing right wrong, God said, I love Jacob and hate Esau. And Esau tried to get right with God and couldn't. Pharaoh tried to get right with God and couldn't do it. He tried to get right. Pharaoh. Remember, I read about Pharaoh in Romans, right? So, he wanted to be a nice, good man, a nice citizen in Egypt, and he wanted to let them go. But, you know, God had a season and a time. So God had to show the plagues in Egypt as a type of the end time. So Pharaoh was not going to disturb God's story, God's typing. So the time you wanted to prematurely let them go, God said no. Because I raised you to show my power. Amen. And that was a shadow of this time. Right? And so the prophet says, if we look at the scriptures superficially, we have a superficial understanding. So when we are talking about who is going into eternal life, who is going to be in the new Jerusalem, in the city, outside the city, it's not a good or bad. This one is good, this is bad. That's a superficial understanding. Right? And when we look at the world, we should look at it with understanding. And when we look at the message as preached by Brother Branham, we should understand that there are many people within range of that message. You save yourself a lot of trouble and a lot of analysis and permutations and headaches. It has to be like that. But God has a plan. All right. Now, we want to look at the group because we don't want to be superficial Christians. Brother Bram nicely in the Sedition Church Age, if you have time, you can go through it, breaks down the categories, all right, of who is who. He says, so we want to look at those groups. So for us to have an understanding, as we interact with the world, as we interact with each other, we must have that broad understanding of what's happening. Then we can make the right decisions. Then we can react appropriately when things happen. In church, at home, at work, because we are not superficial Christians. And when you hear some things behind the desk, then you understand why they are being said. Now, and to start with, this plan is sovereign. It's God's plan. It's not your plan. Amen. Right? Brother Bram says, since this portion of the word is hard for the human mind to grasp, it must be accepted and believed by faith. Right? Some things, some conditions we're going to mention tonight. We know them. We have read the spoken words. We are going to repeat them just now to remind you. But the thing is, you need faith. Because when I tell you Pharaoh was raised for destruction, your human compassion might say, think otherwise. Your human reasoning. But we are not talking about human compassion tonight. We are talking about God's plan. Yeah. And this plan of this God, the God is sovereign. Right? And he's saying there, some will be offended by what I have set forth because they fail to understand the sovereignty of God. Of God, which sets forth that God is God. And because he is God, one cannot defeat his counsels or thwart his will and purpose. Being omnipotent is ruling all affairs and is doing whatever he will with all his creation because all were created for his good pleasure. Amen. He has a right to do this on the grounds of creation alone. Brother Bram says he has a right. Amen. On the grounds of creation. You know, if VW makes a car, and then that car refuses to operate according to their design, then something is very wrong. So you have to go to the chief engineer to sort that problem out. And the car cannot say, no, I want to be this or that. The designer makes it that way and puts the function so that the client can be happy. Right? So he is the right God because he created. Romans 14, verse 7 to 9. For none of us liveth to himself, and no man dieth to himself. For whether we live unto the Lord, and whether we die unto the Lord. Whether we live, therefore, or die, we are the Lord's. For to this end, Christ both died and rose and revived, that he might be Lord both of the dead and living. So God is Lord of the dead, the living, the good, and the evil. Now, when I say it's a God of the good and the evil, the prophet clarifies that, and he says it's not about relationship. We are talking about ownership. To a Christian, he has a relationship. To a sinner, he does not have a relationship. But he owns both the Christian and the unbeliever. So in terms of ownership, he owns everybody. Amen. But in terms of relationship, he doesn't have a relationship with everybody. Amen. That's God. Amen. Jesus paid the price of the whole world, and therefore he can do as he wills with his own. He died on the cross. So he can do what he wants. John 17, verse 2. And thou hast given him power over all flesh, that he should give eternal life to as many as thou hast given him. If we impute omniscience to God, we must also accept that he is perfect in wisdom and righteousness. This plan of election and reprobation, there goes our title, is the wisdom of God revealed in all ages. So this plan of election and reprobation is the wisdom of God. For who knoweth the mind of the Lord that he should instruct him? Rather, let us be the subject in faith to him who is our Father and live. In Israel, in the church, Brother Abraham really hits it hard. He says, now, you might well face it. There's people that will never be saved. There's people that never be saved, no matter what they do. And you know that there's some people that's predestinated to be lost. There's people that's predestined to be saved. All that's predestined to be saved will be saved regardless. And there goes our quotation. God did not reprobate for the sake of reprobation. He reprobated for the sake of the elect. Elect cannot persecute elect. You see? And what you are talking about here is the law of contrast. You cannot appreciate, you know, a wonderful sister, well-dressed, good morals, unless there's an evil woman. Right? And you cannot really appreciate a good, genuine believer unless you see a crook or a thief. So it takes a hypocrite to show that the believer what he is. So it's a broad subject about the sovereignty of God. So the first category, as you all know, let's take it. There are four of them. Right? There are people who are not even born again who go into eternal life, the prophet says. Right? People who did not get the Holy Ghost and were not born again who will be in the New Jerusalem. And we have to stomach that. That is why, saints, as we, like I said, we need to have this not superficial understanding. We now need to tread carefully because you don't know who you are dealing with. At work, in the combi, at home. Maybe the person you are condemning at work, you don't know. As we meet different people, we might not be quick to judge and classify. Well, some people we are meeting, I'm not talking about another age, I'm talking about this age. I cannot speak on behalf of Luther and Wesley, I was not there. I mean, William Branham's time, under his message. And there's a people who are fulfilling the word now. And those people are so precious in the sight of God. Until there are some people who are going to go and have to be given eternal life at the white throne of judgment because of how they interact with you. Amen. So don't be quick to cancel people. Amen. Maybe that person is needing you at that particular point for them to have at the other side. So that's why Pastor says respect people. It's not a compromise. If you thought it was a compromise, it's maturity. But there's a category of people who are not even born again, who go into eternal life. But even superficially consider scripture, the good people go to heaven, the bad people go to hell. But we must understand that with this back, at the back of our mind, with this understanding. There are those who enter into eternal life after the white throne judgment solely on the grounds of being good and kind and just to the elect of God who are his brethren. Then we cannot but accept that by faith. Their names are also in the book of life and they will come up in the second resurrection. And Brother Abraham breaks it down for us, such as the foolish virgins. Yeah? The foolish virgins will seal their testimony by their blood in the tribulation. They will be able to withstand the beast. when the blood is not there. Because when the bride leaves, mercy leaves. Because we are the blood by the Spirit. Brother, what is holding this world is you. When you see the earthquake in Turkey, when you see fires in California, when you see the floods in New Zealand, brother, that's a sign. We don't look at those things blindly. Because judgment has been let loose. Brother Branham was the angel with the last seven vows all put together. And we can hear symptoms of it. That not just floods and earthquakes and just wars. That missile is iconic. It's not just a missile. It's showing what's coming. That we are at the end time. And you better buckle up. The only thing holding this together is you and me. That's how patriotic you are, saints. You are not something which is cheap. That's why they cannot release everything. The winds are being held back. But you can see them coming in. Because when they reject the message, what happens? A temporary plug falls. That's the plan. They reject a messenger, a temporary plug falls. And Brother Branham way back says, America is gone. Don't wait for a rejection to come. They have rejected it. And he prays this present stage of my ministry. All men has forsaken me. And he says in Jeffersonville, that's the only place I preach and people walk out of the service. It was, I said, look, they're walking out in Jeffersonville. Don't look at the rejection coming. We have, it's a rejected Messiah. We are taking side with the rejected king. It's later than you think, saints. Don't just watch those tears. Oh, earthquake. Oh, fire. And why earthquake? Because there's an earthquake judgment coming. Amen. And why fire? There are symptoms of fire coming. Brother, the plagues started falling when Moses and the children of Israel were still in Egypt. The water turned to blood. They were still in Egypt. Right. In this class also, so there's the foolish virgins, righteous of Matthew 25. So the righteous of Matthew 25 is not the bride. In this class also are those who do not worship the beast or become involved in the Antichrist system, but die for their faith, even though they are not in the bride, not having been born again. But they will come up in the second resurrection and go into eternal life. So at the white throne, there's a separation of what? People. The book of life will be opened and another book will be opened. There will be both the righteous and the unrighteous at the white throne judgment. Right? The righteous will not be the bride, for the bride sits with him in judgment. So when you read that scripture, it's not talking about you. Because you'll be sitting with him on the judging. Right? Eternal life is given to them on the grounds that they've been kind and good to brethren. Matthew 25. When the Son of Man shall come in glory and all the holy angels with him, then shall he sit upon the throne of his glory. And before him shall be gathered all nations, and he shall separate them one from another, as a shepherd, divided this sheep from the goats. Right? As a shepherd, Brother Branham emphasizes. And he shall set the sheep on the right hand, but the goats on the left. Then shall the king say unto them on his right. Now, look at that. The king will say unto them, but is the king alone? The king is sitting with the queen. So when he's pointing, he's not pointing to the bride. Because the king is sitting with the queen. And they are pointing. So you are judging with him. Know ye not that the saints will judge angels? and say unto them on this right, come, you blessed of my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. For I was hungered, and you gave me meat. I was thirsty, and you gave me drink. I was a stranger, and you took me in. Naked, and you clothed me. I was sick, and you visited me. I was in prison, and you came unto me. Then shall the righteous answer him, saying, Lord. So they're actually the righteous. When someone does nice things, they are righteous to you. When saw we thee hungered and fed thee, or thirsty and gave thee drink? When saw we a stranger and took thee in, or naked and clothed thee? Or when saw we sick or in prison and come unto thee? And the king shall answer and say unto them, verily I say unto you, insomuch as you have done it unto one of the least of these my brethren, you have done it unto me. Then he shall say unto them on the left, depart from me, you cursed, into everlasting fire, prepared for the devil and his angels. And why are they departing? Because they saw him hungry and did not feed him. They saw him in prison and did not visit him. Sick and did not visit him. Right? So, Brother Abraham says, these people helped the children of God. And like Nicodemus, and Gamaliel. Nicodemus came by night. And Gamaliel. Right? The prophet gives that as an example of the people who are going to make it by name. He mentioned them by name. Nicodemus and Gamaliel. Gamaliel in Acts, he says, don't fight these men. Peradventure will be fighting God. Leave them alone. For that, Gamaliel will enter in. Amen. A Pharisee of the Pharisees. Huh? A Pharisee? And the white throne entering in, making it? Yes, sir. Amen. So tread carefully. Amen. They honor the people of God who were the living manifested word, living epistles for their day. Huh? So they honored the living epistles for that day. And I'm saying we are the living epistle for this day. Amen. So brother, you might be a ticket to somebody's grace at the white throne. Amen. These did not have eternal life, and they are in the judgment. That's why they are in the judgment. They are allowed to go into eternal life. These are those who raise and cast. So there are those who are raised and cast into the lake of fire and will be so treated because of their mistreatment of the brethren. Since this word of God, this is the word of God, we simply accept it. Amen. We don't reason. We calculate. There's no calculation there. Just accept it. Gamaliel, Nicodemus in their day, but there will be the Gamaliels and the Nicodemuses of this day. Who honor the word made flesh, which is you. Brother says there is no argument there. Just a simple statement of fact. Amen. Case closed. You want to fight that fight with the prophet. Amen. Group two. That's group one. Group two. There are those, another group whose names were on the record before the foundation of the world, will have their names removed. Right? So we must also accept that by faith. That's what Brother Brown says in the next quotation. Right. And Brother Brown says, these are the borderline Christians. It's always on the border. You are not sitting on the fence. Perhaps you are a Christian, you are not a Christian. Somewhere there. It's dangerous to sit on the fence. So if you are sitting on the fence tonight, you better make a decision. They failed to obey God, and being void of the Spirit, though even the signs and wonders were amongst them. So are the signs and wonders amongst them? Yes. Right? So we have their names removed from the book of life. amongst this group of the ones like Judas by name, who though entirely void of the spirit but religious, will have manifestation in their lives. Though on the books were not the elected in him, his name was even in the book of life, but his name was blotted out. Such as also Balaam will be in that group. So on the other group, we had an example of Nicodemus, right? And Gamaliel. In this class, or this group, or this category, with Balaam and Judas. So that you know. John 17, verse 12. While I was with them in the world, I kept them in thy name. Those that thou givest me, I have kept. And none of them is lost, but the son of perdition. That scriptures might be fulfilled. So there must be a son of perdition who is there, so that scriptures must be fulfilled. First Peter 2:9, 8:9 shows both reprobates and elect, even to them which stumble at the word, being disobedient, whereunto they were appointed. That's group two. Group three. There are another group. Names never been or will ever be written on the books. Never been or will never be written on the books. There are those names were never placed upon a record of life. We must accept that also by faith. Proverbs 16, verse 4. The Lord hath made all things for himself. Remember, I said he owns everyone, but does not have a relationship with everyone. Yea, even the wicked for the day of evil. And Job 21, the wicked is reserved to the day of destruction. They shall be brought forth to the day of wrath. Jude 4, men of old, predestinated to this condemnation, men turning the grace of God into lasciviousness, gone out after worldly lusts. Right? And it says, for there are certain men crept in and ways who were before of old ordained to this condemnation, ungodly men, turning the grace of our God into lasciviousness and denying the only God and our Father, Lord Jesus Christ. In Timothy, as Jambres and James withstood Moses and Aaron, so will these resist the truth. Men of reprobate mind, God says they'll be there and they are here. Now, Brother Branham in Jehovah Jireh, I didn't have this down, Brother Father, so not to worry. He says, yes, Jehovah Jireh 57, no matter what will take place, there's people in the world that were born not to believe. They were ordained of all to this condemnation. No matter what you do, they wouldn't believe it anyhow. Pharaoh was raised up for this same purpose. Aren't you happy tonight that God turned at your heart to look to Calvary and believe? Like we heard in the morning, you have a prepared breeding ground. Slide 45. The beast thou sowest was and is not, and shall ascend out of the bottomless pit and go into perdition. And they that dwell on the earth shall wander, whose names were not written in the book of life from the foundation of the world, when they behold the beast that was and is not and yet is. So there were people not written in the book of life. They all worship the beast, not the bride. Revelation 17 and 13:8 says, these were ordained of God, but not unto election. And with this group that are as Pharaoh, it says of him, even for this purpose have I raised up the vessels of wrath fitted for destruction. Now, Brabham says, none of these would be placed on the records of life. I'm not saying there's not a record of them. No doubt there is some kind of a record of them, but not in the record of life. Then the final group. Group number four. I think Brother Sivu finish with that group in the morning. the unstoppable seed of Abraham. Now, brother, there are some quotations in some verses who, to these people, you cannot take some verses for them and applying them to the other three categories. And there are some verses which speak of the three categories which you cannot take and apply to this. We need to make peace with that. And it avoids a lot of confusion. Many times we want to twist, we take bright verses and want to apply to category 1, 2, and 3. It won't work. And you take verses, like Brother Brian is telling you that Matthew 25, those righteous, the goats and the sheep being separated, is not the bride. So don't take Matthew 25, the goats and the sheep, and apply to this category. They don't. They don't. And there are some people, some verses, when we speak of this category, you dare not want to try to justify and use human compassion and apply them to other categories. They won't apply. For example, when I speak of a body change has nothing to do with group 1, group 2, group 3. So when I read Thessalonians 5, Paul saying, you know, we shall be changed. There shall be rapture. That's for the Gentile bride. That's for the seed of Abraham. Amen. So you cannot take those quotations and apply them there. You are misplacing scripture. The plan of election and reprobation. We just take these last quotations, then we'll be going home. Right. Brother Benham says, okay, before I go, that's, the names were placed on the record before the foundation of the world cannot, under any circumstances, have those names removed. Amen. Now, your human compassion would want to tell you that, you know, how about this one and that one? It's God's plan. I'm not there. But I'm saying to the bride, not under any circumstances. Brother, there are some people who are going into the rapture, who are going to cheat death, whether they like it or not. It's not your choice. It's not your choice. This is the potter. You are the clay. He molds a vessel unto honor, a vessel unto dishonor. He is sovereign. You cannot ask him why. Maybe when you see him, ask him. I won't. But what I know, there are some people, like we heard in the morning, in their genes, in their bloodstream, brother, they are believers. They were born that way. They have a law of resurrection. They might die, it might be a heart attack, it might be a cancer, it might be a crash. Brother, they'll rise again. Oh, brother, talking about resurrection, it sets my heart on fire. Because that's what you are living for. There are so many saints on the other side. We can't wait to see them. And there's a promise, says, there shall be a resurrection. And God typed it. Brother Rufus, he typed it in Abraham. That was not the real thing. He was showing us there's going to be a body change. And we are the antitype. And as Brother Steve, we said this morning, Abraham was called from ancestral worship, from idol worship. And he was given the promise not by choice. The covenant was unconditional. Now, brother, when I speak of unconditional covenant, I'm not talking about group 1, group 2, group 3. That's why now people say you are giving people a license to sin. No, say. We're not giving anyone a license to sin. We are talking about category 4. It might be a license to sin for group 1, group 2, group 3, because you are misplacing the quotation.
But when I'm talking about group four, that quotation is not misplaced. Amen. Under no any circumstances. God will take you home early, my brother. God will take you home early if you mess around with his mess. But he won't lose you. That's category four. When I talk about God pulling you with an irresistible force on an irreversible course, it's not category one, two, and three. It's category four. Don't dislocate scripture. Church natural, Brother Tafadzwa, church spiritual, there's a church natural, there's a woman here types. So Brother Branham in Seed is not air with the shark. In one message you preach, Seed shall not be air with the shark. The other one he said, Seed is not air with the shark. It depends whom he's talking to. To the outside, he says, Seed shall not be. But when I come to Jefferson Post, post everything will be open there, I say, Seed is not. Present tense. Church natural, church spiritual. So the natural church and the spiritual cannot be as together. So Brother Branham, there, just to put it in context, was talking about Hagar and Sarah. Right? So Hagar and Ishmael and Sarah and Isaac. There are two different separate times. Two different separate peoples under two different separate covenants. Brother, the covenants are different. Brother says they are separate covenants. That God so designed that there are those whose names are placed in a section of the Lamb's Book of Life and cannot be erased. For they are the names of his bride. That we must accept that. The purpose of God stands in election under an unconditional covenant. Now you want to take that and apply to categories, the other categories. You realize God is unfair, God is this, they are categories. Yeah. Don't consider scripture superficially. Amen. Don't scrape it on the surface. Yeah. Amen. He knows. God is so compassionate until to show that he's in control. Giving a glass of water to you, God will recognize it. So don't try to teach him about compassion. He's recognizing the giving of water, a visit to you when you're in hospital. Maybe no brother visits you, or no sister from your church visits you. Your neighbor comes there and visits you. Or your neighbor says, take the car, go to church. Brother, the other time I had a breakdown in my car in the middle of funny place. And you know who helped me? A hobo. Sitting by the shack there. He ran. I was a bit suspicious. The subject clicked and said, no, let me do it. Yeah. Say, is everything fine with all these rags? What is it? Can I do this? Can I do this? So my fuel gauge was malfunctioning, so I used fuel. Can I run and get you fuel? I said, by all means. And I'm waiting there. He goes to the fuel station, brings petrol, pours, and goes. Amen. So to me, God allowed it to break down in that particular place for him to come and help me. I don't come cheap, brother. I don't come cheap. So I'm just looking and he's doing his thing there. And I'm like, okay, that's fine. This man is so inspired, man. He's so inspired. That's the reason the car broke down here. And that's the reason the fuel gauge was not working. God knew at a certain time it's going to break down, it's going to come there, leave his shack from nowhere. Smelling.
and helps a son of God. So respect everybody. So I look at him, maybe that's the last time I watched him disappearing back to the shack. Says, God, you're good. I'll see you someday, my friend. Yeah, you must know your worth. You must know your worth. Someday. The hobo by the highway. The purpose of God says in election under an unconditional covenant. It was purpose in himself. It was God's purpose to bring, it was God's purpose to bring forth a people like unto himself. That would be a wed bride. She was chosen before the foundation of the world in him. She was foreknown and beloved before she was ever brought forth during the ages upon the earth. She was redeemed by his blood and can never come into condemnation. She can never be in judgment. Never. Because sin cannot be imputed unto her. You know, Romans 8, 4 verse 8, blessed is the man to whom the Lord will not impute sin. She shall be with him in his throne of judgment, judging the world, even angels. Her name, each of her members, was written in a section of the Lamb's Book of Life before the foundation of the world. The sheep are in his fold. They heard his word, his voice, and they followed him. They already have eternal life and cannot come into judgment. Brother, our judgment is unto reward. Brother Brian says, I hate my name being called. Amen. You know, in names there was a roll call. Amen. It will be unto reward. Amen. Not judgment for condemnation. Amen. No, say. They'll be saying, brother so-and-so. Brother so-and-so. Amen. And you'll be, well done, Brother Wilson, song leader, preacher. Well done, Brother Brighton. Pastor Burkett. Amen. Brother Stanley. And Brother Bram says, I heard my name. Amen. And he said, I didn't know I was going to be called. And they say, William Branham. And people were clapping. It was like we were coming out of a service. People say, God bless you, Brother Branham. God bless you, Brother Branham. Brother, we are replaying it every day. Yeah? Every day. On the other side, unto reward, not unto condemnation. What a position. Don't lose it. Cherish it. And he reads, we read John 15 already, Brother Tafazo. Let me skip this. Slide 65 as I wind up. He made me what I am without having any choice. I never went back there and said, Charlie, you marry Ella Havi and bring forth me out of the earth. No, say, I've never had no choice of that. God did that. Amen. What you are, God did that. Amen. Remember the Immaculate Conception. Even aren't your very looks, your color, your height, your shades, black, yellow, colored, white, whatever the case might be. He made it that way. But the issue, Malachi 1, the burden of the word of the Lord to Israel by Malachi. I have loved you, said the Lord. You say, wherein hast thou loved us? Was not Esau Jacob's brother, said the Lord. Yet I loved Jacob and I hated Esau and laid his mountains and his heritage waste for the dragons of the wilderness. You see, they could not figure out God's love. They thought that love meant no suffering. They thought that love meant a baby with parental care. But God said that his love was elective. The proof of his love is election. Brother, the proof of his love is not great material things or anything that you might do. His love is election. That he chose you
He called you. He gave you the ability to believe in this message of your day, that you are the written epistle of this hour. God's love is in election. Elective love. Slide 69. He may commit you to death as he did Paul. He may commit you to suffering as he did Job. That is his prerogative. He is sovereign. But it's all with a purpose. That's the reason you staggered out of these things and staggered into what you have now. It was God leading you to the place where he had ordained for you to be. If this ground is prepared beforehand, isn't prepared beforehand, it can't grow. In the sight of God, the bride is justified. She never done it. The bride. Not anyone else. Remember, I said these are quotations that apply to category 4. If you want to apply them to other categories, you are misconstruing quotation. It won't work. That's why you have a cow grazing grass on the top of a tree. And you struggle with this. Put back the cow in the field where there's meadows of green grass. Standing there, Brother Wilson, as you come, my brother, married to the visual Son of God, never sinned in the first place. Why? She was foreordained. She was trapped into this. Brother, you were trapped. And now when she heard the truth and come forth, the blood cleansed her. And she stand there virtuous. No sin on her at all. The simplicity of it just confuses the great powerful intellectual mind that tries to make him some great something that is not. He is with us. He is here with us. He is part of you. He is a fiber of you. We are the flesh of his flesh and the bone of his bone. We are part of him because we are his children. And God dwells in us just like he did in his Son, Christ Jesus. Brother, can you stomach that? God dwells in us just like he did in his Son Jesus. The fullness of God is in the bride. She is him. Bone of his bone, flesh of his flesh. Oh, brother, every type, every shadow in the Old Testament is being fulfilled now. Talk about Rahab. Talk about Abigail. Talk about Sarah. Talk about Mary. All of them were pointing to you. Brother, Moses was even taken into the mount and shown the pattern of the tabernacle in heaven and was told to replicate it on earth as a shadow of the end time. I trust you in church tonight. God took Moses and showed him the tabernacle in heaven. And they built it in the wilderness. And that showing in heaven, building in heaven, on the earth, was a type of the end time. You are not a type. Brother Brown says, Enoch, the seventh from Adam, knew that he was a type. When he took that straw, he knew that he was a type of the end time. The disciples on the Mount of Transfiguration, they were typing the second coming, which is now. We are not typing anything. We are the ultimate. The saints on the other side are hoping and are waiting for you to know who you are. It's a mystery of completion. The final piece of the jigsaw puzzle completes the puzzle. Over the years, God has been letting out this mystery. It's now made flesh. That's why saints, when you come to church, we must realize who we are. You are more than special. Rather, we have saints that are gone on the other side. They're waiting. We have elders that are gone on the other side. They depend on this message. They are saying, we preached it. We are waiting for the fruit of our laboring for all the years. And brother, they will not be disappointed. This bride is going to overcome Laodicea. Brother Brown says the end time message will meet end time conditions. It was designed to meet end time conditions. We are going out of this world in victory. Laodicea is not going to overcome us. We are unstoppable. We are the Abraham seed with Abraham faith. Brother, we have brothers like Daniel. In the lion's den, they threw him. But the lions couldn't eat him. It was a type of you. There was Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. They raised the temperature of the furnace, but they could not be burnt. It was a type of you. They were shadowing you and me. Here we are, saints. Let's be courageous. Let's grab the bull by the horn. Let's fight the fight of faith. They on the other side cannot be perfect without us.
May God bless you.
Let us stand, dear ones. Thank you for Brother Stanley for teaching. Let us pray in worship. Father God, we thank you. Thank you for your unfailing word. Thank you for your unfailing promise. Lord, we appreciate you. We glorify you. We honor you. You are our everything. It's because of you that we are here, O Lord, this evening. You brought us to this world, to the earth, in this age. You chose, O God, which country we will be placed. And Father, you knew when this message will find us, O Lord, and this message found us, Lord, and bring us back to our remembrance. Lord, as the prophet said, we suffered from spiritual amnesia, Lord. Thank you for the message of the hour that took away, O Lord, amnesia, Lord. And you have brought us a God, hallelujah, the message of the hour. You said, I will send you Elijah the prophet before the great and dreadful day of the Lord. And we thank you for the message. Thank you for everyone that you, of God, hallelujah, whose names you wrote on the Lamb's Book of Life. The prophet said you wrote it with your own blood, Lord. And it cannot be erased, O Lord, from the Lamb's Book of Life, Lord. We thank you, Lord, Father. What a promise word we have for our day, Lord, Father. Oh God, Father, Lord, we don't need to say we're going to see that day. We know, O Lord, Father, if we meet the requirements of your word, Lord, Father, God, the prophet has come and said that you have already made it for us, Lord. We don't need to struggle and to fuss, Lord, Father. God, we must just believe the word. We must just lay in the sun and live the life, Lord, God, that expected of us as end-time believers, Lord. God, Father, you have, O God, sent your Holy Ghost, O Father. Lord, to Father, God, O Lord Jesus, rid us of all things, sin, unbelief, doubts, and fear that doesn't belong in a believer's life, that isn't part of our makeup, Lord, Father. Our makeup is the word, Lord. We can truly say tonight that we came from God and we came back, go back to God. We are here in a testing ground. We are here preparing for eternity, Father. We thank you for our brother Stanley. Thank you that you used him, Lord. God, we never chose you. You chose a Father, us in you, O Father. And that's why we can say tonight with confidence, Father, we are sons
and we are daughters of a living God. We are the bride of the Lord Jesus Christ. We appreciate you, Lord. We love you, O Lord. Give us grace, O God. Grace for each day. Hallelujah. To serve you in spirit, Lord, and in truth. In the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you very much. Hallelujah. Amen. Did you enjoy the word, dear ones?
Amen.
I have to apologize. I forgot to pray for a prayer request. I just read it and I didn't pray for it. So let's pray for it first. God, we love you. We say thank you. Here's Sister Michelle's request of Aunt Pauline Smith, whose flat burnt out, Lord. Father, thank you that nobody died or were burnt in the fire, Lord. But Father God, I pray that you will provide for them, Lord Father. It could have happened in the middle of the night, Lord Father. Oh God, when everybody was fast asleep, Lord. But Father God, you know when and what you do, Lord Father. I pray that you will strengthen them and comfort them, and will you open hearts towards them. Also the city, Father, on who the building belongs, that they will also hurry up. And Father God, hallelujah, they always drag feet where these things are concerned to fix the people's damaged and burnt property. But I trust and pray that you will wonderfully come through for Father Sister Michelle's auntie, Lord. We give you praises, glory, and honor. Yes, also Rugia, that is looking for accommodation, Lord. I pray that you will undertake for her, that you will foresee for her. We all need a roof over our heads, Lord Father, and I trust and pray that you will undertake for her, Lord. Thank you for our dear sister Sophia Matun, Lord God, that is also thanking the pastor and his wife and the saints and the ministry, oh Lord, for the time that she had also with a daughter, a son-in-law, a grandchildren. We trust and pray that you will grant my sister safe traveling mercies back to Namibia, Lord, on Tuesday. And we trust that you'll strengthen her, touch her body, Lord, touch her from her feet to her head, Lord, every organ in her body for the glory of God. Lord, as our pastor, will you also bring him safe home, Lord, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. We're going to sing Who I Am. A glorious victory.
Who I am, Lord, who I am. Thank you.
God, we ask the question to ourselves, who I am, Lord, who I am. Thank you, Lord, we are part of you, bone of you, flesh of you. You have made your indwelling in our hearts, into our souls, Father God. And you made your abode, O Father God. That's what we can say tonight. We are part of you. And Father God, we love you tonight. And we appreciate you, Lord, for all your mercies and your grace upon our lives. Thank you, Lord, that you feed us every day, O Lord. God, with the word, O Lord. With the vitamins, Lord. It is the vitamins of the word that keeps us, O Father God. We cannot keep ourselves, O Lord, Father. We are insufficient to keep ourselves, but we depend on you, the Holy Spirit, Lord, to lead us, to guide us, and to feed us, Lord, in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Lord. We sing Where Eagles Dare.
149.
We have been born in the eagle land by an eagle prophet's message. Manifest the loving word of our day. We have been given wings to fly. We have been in the sky. Living in a heavenly atmosphere, fire will lead us there. Let's fly so high where the word of God. A message that brought us out from this world of fear and doubt. Have been given eyes to see all the mysteries of living. Our lives are fulfilling prophecy.
Amen.
Our position in God's will. Ooh, fire will only lead us through. Ooh, let's fly so high where the word of God is. And everything to land. Oh, let's fly.
Tommy, please, to close in a word of prayer. Brother Tommy. Thank you.
Amen. Let's bow our heads together. Heavenly Father, we want to say thank you for a day really well spent in your presence, Lord. Our hearts are just so blessed tonight, Lord. And Father God, we look at this flesh. We cannot, the mind, Lord, cannot reason what was spoken over this desk tonight, Lord Jesus. Lord, like Peter, we say, Lord, if it be thee, bid us come. Lord, we walk out on the word and we say, Lord, Father, let it be unto us according to thy word, Lord. We're so grateful there's an attribute within that says amen to that word, Lord. Something that flies much higher, Lord, than what the flesh and the reasoning, the senses of the body and the senses of the spirit can cast at us, Lord. We're so grateful for that seed gene, that attribute, Lord. Father, what would we do without it? We're so grateful for that inner voice, Lord. We thank you for the Holy Ghost, Lord Jesus. We thank you for the Spirit of God that dwells in your people, Lord. It keeps us sane in an insane age, Lord. We appreciate you tonight, Heavenly Father. We're so grateful for your mercies upon our lives, Lord. We, Lord, just lay ourselves at your feet, Lord, and we say, Lord, thou art the potter. We are but the clay, Lord. Think of that beautiful old hymn, Lord. Mold us and make us after thy will while we are yielded, wounded and still, Lord Jesus. Bless us, Father. There's a week that lies ahead. Lord, these events of the past weeks have shaken us, Lord. It's just incredible how things can change so quickly. It makes us turn to you, Lord. It makes us cling closer to you. And so we pray, Lord, may your grace be with us in the week. May you be with every child that goes to school, every father, mother, and father that goes to work, that looks after the children, every homeschooling parent, Lord. Father, every grandparent, everyone, Lord, may your grace overshadow us in a special way, Lord. And we just commit ourselves to you, and we ask these things in Jesus' name. Amen.
God bless you. You may be seated, dear ones. Thank God for his mercies. As the brothers, deacons, dismiss you. So have a blessed week. We don't know what tomorrow will bring, but we know who holds tomorrow. Amen. Praise God.